Hello and welcome once again to another edition of IFN News.
Charlie Kiss, thank you for taking the time to talk to IFN News today. If you could just let our viewers know who you are.
I'm the candidate for Islington South and Finsbury for the Green Party. And obviously I was aware of what happened to young Henry Hicks that night in December. But more recently I was alerted to the fact that he'd been stopped and searched 156 times over a period of 3 years. That works out about once a week. And that horrified me, because I thought, what on earth was happening? What on earth is going on for somebody to be stopped for that many times and not having any previous record or anything?
Well, it's quite staggering, isn't it?
It is.
We do notice that in Islington there's been quite an upturn, or at least there's been the revealing of an upturn in crimes involving youth, and there's been people involved in stabbings a lot around here this year, and it's a great concern for the public. So it's very good that you come forward to make that statement. I mean, I have noticed that we have approached the other politicians in the area, we have approached the prospective candidates, and not so many have been wishing to come forward to voice their opinions.
Yes, it's it's strange that, really, because I also noticed in a newspaper question and answer session that I was the only one who talked about issues of youth crime and the worry that lots of people do have about young people being stabbed, and I suggested some ideas of what we should do. But there are a lot of issues going on here. One is demonisation of young people. I see too often when you have one young person, maybe just with one other, being asked to move on. But surely we don't want a situation where all young people have to stay indoors all the time. That's not good for anybody. People should be allowed to go on the streets, to parks. They should be allowed to be with their friends without being stopped and searched.
Well, I think most of the public would have to agree with a sentiment such as that. What exactly would the Green Party policy be, perhaps, towards the stop and search? This has been quite a notable issue that people have not been very happy about as well.
Yes, well, we do have a policy of wanting to stop disproportionate stop and search. We do have other policies as well that not many people probably would know about, and that is we want to bring the police back into the community. They must live in the area. What we have at the moment, partly because of the housing problem again, is we've got police staff living miles away, not even in London, having free travel to come and work in the centre of London. And of course they don't know the area and they don't know the people. I mean, I am for community policing, and this has to happen, really.
Yeah, it is. I recall on the day of the march, on April the 4th, there was a few thousand people that passed through this street. We recorded that event, and when we got to the police station there was absolutely no reception there. Now, I do know that the new borough commander had promised in the paper just the previous day that she would meet with the family and that she would talk to them, and they were expecting to meet her, but she didn't show up. I'm not asking you to be too committed about a statement, Charlie.
That is disappointing, I would say, and I would hope that she would meet the family at least.
So in short, if you were to summarise up?
If I was to summarise, the stop and search. Well, I was going to say that the stop and search doesn't exactly promote good relations between young people and the police. It doesn't seem to me very necessary. There are other ways in which we have to stop this sort of us and them attitude, and that isn't the way to go about it.
Okay, so the way forward, obviously, you are the Green Party candidate, and if I may draw you on this again, so your policy would be to review the stop and search?
Yes. Well, we'd do lots of things. We want to bring back funding to youth centres. We want to give young people hope. Very difficult to be a young person at the moment. You can't go to college without having a lot of money. You get saddled with debt. There's no real job opportunities. The economy is stagnating. All of these things actually are contributing to a feeling of alienation, really, I would say.
Okay. Charlie Kiss, thanks for taking your time out today. I know it's been a difficult subject to talk on, and it's quite controversial, but I'm sure that the members of the community that have asked for someone to respond, I'm sure they'll be quite grateful for this. Charlie, thanks very much for your time today.
Well, thanks for talking to me.
From the team and myself, thanks for joining us today.